Hello, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lori. I'm sitting here, I'm going over the final tally for the past 5 weeks. My grocery budget, I wanted to get it trimmed, and so I'm just kind of doing a check-in with you on how I did. My original plan was to start out with $70 a week and, you know, see how that would do for us. That is 2 adults, 6 cats, 2 Pomeranians. That includes, when I say groceries, I include food, litter, dish soap, shampoo, toothpaste. You know, I include everything. And so I started out with $70 a week thinking, you know, that's a good place to start. I have no problem raising it if I need to. I had looked back over several months and the average was about $150 a week that I was spending. And I just kind of questioned that a little bit. So I just pulled $70 out of the air. You know, I just said, cut it in more than half and we'll see, you know, where we can go from there. So I did really good for the first 2 weeks. You know, menu planning and list making, and I did really well. I stayed at the $70 and everything was great. Then life happened, as it often does. But I really just let it run away with me. I did. We had a very exciting thing happen. Our first grandchild was born, and so between the hospital visits and, you know, when they came home, going down to visit them and such, menu planning and list making just went right out the door, you know, right out the window. It's like, okay. I didn't realize how far I'd gone out the window, but then we've had some other things. People close to us making what they consider their life decisions, and they shouldn't affect anybody else, but they do. They affect all of us, and it's not life or death or anything like that, but I have taken it on, and that's just who I am, so that has affected me, and I haven't gotten back into the menu planning and whatnot. Excuse me. So I let that run away with me. And then we had winter storms. We had a pretty easy winter. And this last, I don't know, month, I guess, we've had snowstorms. And this last one was a doozy. And I usually try really hard not to let them panic me. I try not to be the person that says, snow is coming, get to the store and get your eggs, your milk, and your bread. Because I always try to have that on hand. But this last storm, 20 inches plus, was coming. And I just kind of panicked. And I ran to the store and I got eggs, milk, bread, and walked by the ice cream and said, oh, we might want some, you know. And so $33 later, when we really needed nothing. So it has been 5 weeks, February 10 to March 10. It's been 5 Fridays, I should say. Those 5 Fridays all combined, I spent $796 now. Is that over $70 a week? Yeah. Yeah, $70 a week would have been $350. So I more than doubled that. But I'm giving myself some grace. You know, I'm not going to freak out about it. The freezer sure is stocked. The cupboards sure are stocked. You know, we are good to go. Aside from fresh produce, that is what we are going to need for this coming month. So, I am not going to say that I will not spend anything other than fresh produce. You know, I'm not gonna say that. But, you know, it shouldn't, there's no reason that it should be close to $796 again for this coming month. But, you know, so do I need to raise it? Yes, obviously. But like I said, I don't need to raise it back up to the $150 a week. Not yet. That's not proven to me. So I'm getting back on the menu planning and the list making, and I have menu planned for the next, so far I've gotten 6 days here. So that's, you know, that's good. And I'm making a little list here of things that I need to supplement what we have. Our neighbor today brought over a lasagna. So for supper tonight, we're going to have lasagna, homemade lasagna. It looks really delicious. So, tomorrow night, I think I will have beef stew. I have some roast beef left over from a beef that I, from a roast that I had made a couple of days ago. I made roast beef and mashed potatoes. And then the next night we had, barbecue roast beef on, you know, sandwiches, and homemade fries. And so I have some beef left over and the gravy. And so we're going to have beef stew. I have meatloaf in the freezer, so we're going to have that on Sunday. Potatoes and vegetable roll in a butter. Roll in a butter. Roll in butter. Monday we'll have turkey and noodles, mashed potatoes, and vegetables. I already have the turkey and homemade noodles all done. I made a huge batch of it last week, 2 weeks ago. And froze part of it, so... and then on Tuesday, we're going to have salmon patties, brown rice, and broccoli. I do not have brown rice, so that is on my list. I will run and buy that on Sunday, along with, you know, our fresh produce. But, so I need to finish out the rest of the week, or the rest of the month. I have, 4, 5, 6, I have 10 more days to fill out here. And, it's going to be stuff like, you know, chicken, grilled chicken breast and, vegetable, and probably some, quinoa. I have quinoa that, that I want to use. And, you know, I don't know. I'm hoping that the sun comes out at some point, you know, obviously it's out today, I know, but warm weather also. And it'll melt enough, the snow will melt enough, we can get to the grill, get it lit, and it'll be warm enough, the temperature will be up. Because I would like to do a day of grilling. In the summertime, my husband usually fires up the grill on Saturday or Sunday, and he does hot dogs, hamburgers, and chicken, and get it all cooked up, all grilled up. And then I freeze it and we eat it for that week, lasts a month, you know, whatever. And so I would like to get a day of that in here shortly and, you know, have that in the freezer too. So anyway, that's what I've got going so far. I'm going to finish up my menu here. And yeah, I just wanted to check in with you and just let you know that, you know, the month was an epic failure in sticking to $70 a week. But if that's all you're looking at, you know, that was a failure. But I'm not just looking at that. I got a brand new grandbaby out of it. And so I am thrilled. I'm very grateful that we had that money to spend on groceries. And, you know, that's just where I'm going to come from on that. But I'm still going to work at this. I'm still going to see, you know, if I can help trim up that spending just a little bit, excuse me. Anyway, so, I'm getting into rambling now and I'm sorry about that. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you would, please subscribe, hit that little bell. So you get notifications of when I put videos up. I usually do it about once a week. I try to. I have, just let me say, I have the utmost respect for people that keep up with this. Number one, for people that keep up with the budgeting that they say and they stick under, you know, their budgets that they have set and they do their menu planning and they do their lists and everything. Great respect. I have great respect for you. And number two, I have great respect for people that actually vlog it, that actually do a great job in, you know, telling everybody, hey, I did this. This is what we did. You can too. And because I've just really fallen down on that. It's tough. It is very tough. And I just have great respect for everybody that is doing it and keeping up and at least trying and whatnot. And I just wanted to check in and say, hey, I am still trying. I was supposed to spend $350 for the 5 Fridays, 5 weeks. And I spent $796. So there we go. I'm giving myself some grace. So have a great day and I will talk to you later. Bye.